News 4 continues following a developing story our investigative team has been tracking for months. Two cities in St. Louis County are now being sued in federal court.
And you can buy up to 3.6 grams of Sudafed a day in Illinois. These two boxes together contain that much. If I took the maximum of each of these, this box would last me a week. This one would last me 18 days. Regular users would never need the max amount of this in a day. So there's definitely a red flag when someone goes store to store to store trying to buy these.
That there are more than 700 security cameras in this area, and there's about to be a whole lot more. I am told that this area is actually going to get cameras that focus on license plates. That way, people always know who is coming into this area specifically so they can pay attention to whether there are any stolen cars.
So that attorney just referenced Tom McGee, who is the mayor's attorney. So there are three major players in this. All three of them now have attorneys. As for the problems with the mayor, those do not end here. He does have a December court date for his two felonies stemming from that original incident with the cyclist. Guys, one thing is for sure in all of this, you can depend on News 4 to continue following this story for all of you.
And millions of people ride the New York City subway system every single day, but something else is hitching a ride on the rails. It's a whole lot of gross and a whole lot of gross germs.
Medicines like these, any decongestant, basically anything that contains pseudoephedrine. As many of you know, that is the main active ingredient in meth. The video you are seeing is from a training session I went to yesterday in the Metro East. Might be hard to tell, but guys, take a look at this. That is an active meth lab. You see black strips floating in that bottle. That's lithium that meth makers pull from batteries. And those white clusters at the very bottom are pills of pseudoephedrine.
I've covered many fires. Typically, firefighters do not give you a reason unless they are absolutely sure of the cause. And last night, firefighters out at the scene told our crews that they believe a mattress was in a bottom storage unit here. It caught on fire and the flames spread from there.
Since we are so close to spring training, I thought I would put this into some perspective for you by throwing in some Cardinals numbers. How about that? Now, every night the Cardinals play at Busch, there's usually between 43 and 44,000 fans there. Well, that is just about as many cars and trucks that take this bridge every single day.
We're finding out about burglars armed with trash cans turning violent in South St. Louis.
I just ran the crime statistics for the month of January. From January 2014 to January 2015, crime in this area went up 20%. And also, as for these license plate recognition cameras, there's supposed to be at least 5 in the next few months, and the goal is to eventually have 30 in this area.
This is where that fire broke out last night. Doesn't look like there's much damage at all. In fact, we were able to talk to a police officer on the scene this morning. He tells us the majority of the damage is inside the building, not too much wrong with the outside of the building.
But of course, they suggest, hey, why don't you give it a try? You might like it. I'm going to take their advice because I'm going home to the great state of Illinois later today. I'll be on that bridge. I'll be one of the 40,000.
Today marks 6 months since the shooting death of Mike Brown, which spurred protests across the area. And now we are getting a better idea of which businesses will reopen following last year's unrest.
Now to a story you will only see right here on News 4 this morning.
Thousands of you saw this commercial run during the Super Bowl ad. Mm-hmm. Take a look.
And that's how you got addicted to heroin.
Our Laura Hediger saw it as a way to find out more about the deadly drug and as a way to find out how to talk to your child about it. She joins us live from the newsroom. Laura, experts say it's never too early to have the drug talk.
You are exactly right, Emily. Those with the NCADA, in fact, tell me that kids as young as kindergartners can really start to learn about these topics, and you can use any teachable moments that you can. You can use this story if they are in the room with you right now, or maybe there's a song that's going to come on the radio as you're driving them to school that mentions drugs or alcohol. Use those examples to discuss when someone can use a prescription drug, and if you don't know where to start, telling them about alcohol is a good place.
I would suggest really talking first and foremost about alcohol, setting boundaries about what is okay, what is not okay, setting real consequences. I don't think there's anybody who starts with heroin. They start with alcohol, they start with tobacco, they start with marijuana.
substance, maybe high schoolers who drink, before they are 15 years old are 4 to 6 times more likely to grow up and have a substance abuse problem. And get this, more than 340 people just in St. Louis County died from an overdose in 2013. To put that into some perspective, I contacted St. Louis County Police. They tell me they investigated 15 homicides that same year. And I get more feedback from you, the viewers, about these stories than any other crime or trend I track. So after the show, I'm going to put together a story for our website, KMOV.com, include certain warning signs to look for and other tips for how you can talk to your child about this. We'll send it back to you guys.
And Laura, you've been tracking drug problems on both sides of the Mississippi River.
News 4 is always tracking crime, watching out for your safety. And tonight, we are following an increase in murders, stolen cars, robberies, and assaults, all of that plaguing downtown St. Louis. That as police and different organizations figure out how to keep you safe when you come to the heart of the city. Only on News 4, Laura Hediger shows you the plan of attack.
I don't think that crime is truly more of a factor than it was before. Unfortunately, there have been a few that have been a little bit more audacious.
Especially this one, the murder of Bobby Christman right outside the City Museum in early January. It happened a block off Washington Avenue. Since then, we've seen hotspot policing and the pledge to make this destination neighborhood safer.
Washington Avenue gets a lot of focus from the police and from our organization in terms of amping up the security.
According to Missy Kelly with Downtown STL Inc., the new focus will be on reading license plates, specifically in the downtown and downtown west neighborhoods. The goal is to recognize stolen cars or cars involved in crimes. Take this crime that happened last Monday, for example. This silver Pontiac was reported stolen in Granite City. According to police, bad guys took them on a chase across the river and into the city of St. Louis. License plate cameras would be able to recognize that plate as soon as it would be registered as stolen. Here's the main reason these two neighborhoods will get the technology first.
We will always make sure that our entertainment district has more safety, more security, and more rules.
The cameras will most likely be positioned on light poles or stop lights. According to those with Downtown STL Inc., there should be 5 up and running by March. The price tag for those first 5 is nearly $70,000. Then the goal is to have 30 over the next 2 years. Reporting downtown, Laura Hediger, News 4.